I think the Bears are taking a pretty big leap of faith here. I think Phil Emery is a guy who, during his famous press conference, earned the benefit of the doubt. And I think we're going to exercise that and give him that right now, because you just passed up hiring the NFL Coach of the Year in Bruce Arians. You had Bruce Arians in the building yesterday for an extensive second interview, and a guy who has been, a head coach with the Colts and coming off a 9-3 stint as an interim guy, and you passed up that opportunity. So I think that, the pressure shifts a little bit to Phil Emery, because we are going to be asked, Chicago is going to be asked to trust him. And I think he's given us reason to believe that he knows what he's doing. But it is interesting. There's some risk involved. There's always going to be risk involved. But you just fired a coach who went 10-6 to hire a guy who's been out of the league since 2004. I know he's been a head coach in Montreal. It is a CFL. There's the same amount of risk involved, probably, as in elevating a college coach to this job. So I think that it's a fascinating hire. It's very consistent with the way the Bears, do unorthodox things with their head coaching position. But I think that everyone's going to keep an open mind and give Mark Trestman a chance to show us and justify the faith that Phil Emery's placed in him. So I think that Mark Trestman is a guy who, from what I have learned about him and talking to people, sounds similar to Phil Emery. Very meticulous, very detail-oriented, very intellectual, a guy who is a thinker. They probably hit it off. And I imagine that symmetry and that ability to coexist. And, look, Phil Emery used the word synergy, I think, 9 times during his press conference in announcing the firing of Lovie Smith. He was looking for synergy. And I think he might have found it with the guy who he's like-minded with. And I'm not saying he didn't with Bruce Arians, but I think that if, we're getting indications that the Bears wanted to keep some of the defensive staff intact. I don't think that can be discounted as a factor here, because it looks like Trestman might be more willing to do that than Arians was. Not that that was the final decision, but I think it might have made you feel better if you're Phil Emery, that this was a guy who was on the same page philosophically as you were and had reinforced all the things you thought about him at the first interview. So it's going to be exciting and interesting to get to know this guy a little bit better. And it's a new day at House Hall.